Once again, welcome to the Cool Out Mix, each and every Thursday right here on WLVS Radio, man. You can catch me live from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. We feature poetry, neo-soul, R&B, and we support the indie hip-hop on the first two tracks of the show. And every third Thursday, we'll have either an indie hip-hop artist in here or I'm going to do that mix for you. And we support DMV and all over. So I got a special guest in here today. I got Chris Poetry Childs Thomas. He's going to be blessing the mic. And also WRTR hosting here, Marcus Smooth. Hey, Marcus, what's up, man? What's going on? All right, that's what's up, man. So this is how we do it this weekend, but let me get through all the events. This weekend is also Next to Blow. My man Marcus, he's going to be there. We supporting all the DMV artists, man. All the way from, it's from ATL to the DMV. We're supporting the man. Got an all-day event on Saturday at Axum Lounge. And then we're going to take it over to Lace Lounge on Rhode Island Avenue on Sunday. And we're just going to party all weekend, man, and also support these artists. So if you're an artist and the list is already full, but come out and support. So come out and support, bring your CDs with you, bring your tracks with you so we can go ahead and all the media outlets will be there for just to support the artists and receive the tracks. So so we good with that, right, Marcus?
Absolutely. Got it.
Okay. So, you know, so we just bringing stuff out. I invited a lot of people out, man. So come on out, support, man. Bring your material with you so you can shake hands with everybody, network, and man, and get your tracks played. That's how, what we do, man. We support all brands of artists, man. So we're just doing it. So Nicole, ATL Talent, I heard the tracks and I will get with you later. So appreciate the support. We are definitely going to network and get Cam Major in here and get everyone else, all your other artists in here. And I'm supporting, man. So, hey, first track I got, man, it's a little different than hip-hop, but it's Laugh Now and Cry Later. Hey, cuz, I told you I was going to play it, man. Jimmy Brandt out of Water really made this track a couple of years ago, man. And now he's putting it out, man. He feel like his talent is being, he set it to the side, and now he don't want to waste his talent, man. So let's check him out, man.
You'll be spectators. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, ain't stop the fat lady from singing. Laugh now, shorty, cry later. Cause while I'm chilling in paradise, you'll be spectators. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, ain't stop the fat lady from singing. Laugh now, shorty, cry later. Don't wanna be a spectator like the rich man pleading for a drop of water for his tongue. There's no relief cause it's done. Y'all persecute me cause I'm in submission to the sun. Up in the gym getting buff and stuff, feeling like you tough, getting ready for the summer so you can floss outside your home. And I know we going out on a limb, that's what we do. Like Paul, I'm not only willing to be put in chain, but willing to die for the truth. Only ride with my crew, young zealous soldiers for the gospel. 37 mighty men with tools and weapons cause it's hostile. My tool is my microphone, my weapon is my Bible. That chrome 44 won't do nothing for your survival. Laugh now, shorty, cry later. Cause while I'm chilling in paradise, you'll be spectators. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, can't stop the fat lady from singing. You don't reject me, you reject Christ. I don't preach me, I preach Christ. Not an ounce of sweat off my brow. The more you scoff at me, the bigger my crown. I believe the more you clown our ministry, the better it sounds. Dog, I see you through these speakers holding your head. Straight convicted, in your room ready to give your life to him. But scared of what your family and what your mans and them might say. But do you think them cats gonna stand with you on judgment day? So what you say? Are you willing to give it up to be a man? And find out what's in store for you in God's plan. But here we go again. You about to hit eject a wilder with your clan. The same cycle all over again, round and round again. Laugh now, shorty, cry later. Cause while we chilling in paradise, you'll be spectating. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, can't stop the fat lady from singing.
As I shared before, meditate on Psalm 44. Used to have enemies galore, now it's a spiritual war. Jesus put me on the front line. I share with young cats about being left behind. Man always had his money on his mind. Many men, they love a life of sin. They won't even listen to the song. Knowing what I'm spitting, they wrong. They rather die chasing a diamond or thong. Lifted by popping several heads off a bottle of mo. In the club being hard like Pharaoh. In life, everybody wants to be a star in his own movie promo. Lord, help me preach to your creation who just don't know. Father, forgive us for what we do. When I share your word, they don't know. They persecute me, they blaspheme you. See, I've been talked about and put down, but it's worth the crown. This some Christian is saying it sound. No longer hellbound, so I work on my salvation with fear and trembling. Rather eternal life than burn like a gremlin. Sun haze is hot, God cast my lot. Thank Jesus for being persecuted by the Romans plot. They crucified Jesus, they stoned Stephen, but in the spirit, there's no getting even. Laugh now, during the rapture, I'll be leaving. Shorty cry later, cause while I'm chilling in paradise, you'll be spectators. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, can't stop the fat lady from singing. Laugh now, shorty cry later, cause while I'm chilling in paradise, you'll be spectators. Don't get me wrong, I pray one day you do a 180. But if you continue on this path, can't stop the fat lady from singing.
Freak, line it up and let it OD. Tuck a Molly though, like she can hardly blow. After that, the bitch go deep. Middle fingers to all them haters. Talking shit to you, know me. Built to last, not killed for mass. Have the doctors rebuild your ass. Damn, slicker can't go no quicker. Tip the bottle till it fills the glass. Kicked me straight out of high school. Got drafted to the realest class. Now I'm rolling with a street team. Always down to let the heat scream. In and out of that system, we can really show you the street mean.
We can get paper, money over lies. Once I see the hate in the eyes, I can smell a homicide, homicide. I can smell a homicide, homicide. These niggas be faking, these niggas be hating. Run up on them at night, these niggas get taken off. These niggas some hoes, these niggas ain't real. Talk about that strap, to pull that strap on and chill. We be getting paper, money over lies. Once I see the hate in his eyes,
that hood lights, where hell's that? Homicide and we smell that. Half these niggas just be getting away. Never see them where sell at. Cops popping every so often. Pay attention, you slow caution. We ain't trying to get clapped up, strapped up, no option. Niggas always be popping off. When you see them, they don't say much. Breaking bread just to get inside us. Being niggas paged up. Getting money, that's not a lie. See the hater in a lot of eyes. Guns popping and bodies dropping. Get a whiff of that homicide.
We be getting paper. Money over lies. Once I see the hate in the eyes, I can smell a homicide.
Smell it.
I can smell a homicide. Homicide. These niggas be faking. Hey. These niggas be hating. Hey. Run up on them at night. Hey. These niggas get taken on. These niggas some hoes. Hey. These niggas ain't real. Hey. Talk about that strap. To pull that strap on and chill. We be getting paper. Money over lies. Once I see the hate in his eyes, I can smell a homicide, homicide. They can smell a homicide, homicide.
These yeah. Bitch niggas, yeah. Some lame niggas, some lame niggas. All up in my lane, nigga. I aim, nigga. Aim, nigga. Bang, nigga. Bang, nigga. Hang, nigga. Talking about your brains, nigga. Brains, nigga. Now you shit to change, nigga.
Got a sick grip and keep it going, freak. Line it up and let it out with me. Talking about Lee, that one, she can hardly blow. After that, the bitch go deep.
All right, welcome back to the Cool Out Mix, man, with your boy DJ Clapper, man. And we are cooling out, man, each and every Thursday right here at WLVS Radio. You can also check out my new website, www.coolout.com. So check that out. And you just heard Tef Banger, that's Homicide. You heard my man Jimmy Brent, man, that's Laugh Now, Cry Later. That was the first track played. So Tef Banger will be at the next To Blow Rated for Radio this weekend, performing Homicide and just all his tracks, man. So come out and support, man. You know what I'm saying? I got my special guests in here. They ready to go, man. Chris Poetry, Charles Thomas, and my man Marcus Smooth for WRTR. So, hey, Chris, how you doing, man?
Doing good tonight. What's up with you?
Hey, man. Welcome to the show, brother. I'm glad you come through, man. Glad I finally got you in here, man.
Yeah, it took forever, right?
It's all good. It's all good, man. So this is how we do it, man. We support the poets, man. We support hip-hop. We support the neo-soul. Support the neo-soul and everything. I met Chris at a couple of events that I DJed at. And, man, the guy is awesome. He's awesome, man, with his work, his craft, man. He's serious about it. He got a story to go with it, man. And I enjoyed it, man, and asked him to come on the show, man. So this is how we do it, man. I'm not going to take up too much more time because I really like to spotlight the artist. So, hey, Chris, whenever you ready, man. So first, I take that back. I want everybody to know how to get a hold of you.
You can get a hold of me on Twitter at PoetryChild, and that's PoetryChild. And also on Instagram with PoetryChild, same spelling. Facebook at Christopher Thomas, in parentheses is PoetryChild.
Mm-hmm. And the sex tape will be out next week.
Actually, it'll be out tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Hot off the press. Hey, that's what's up, brother, man. So what made you get into poetry, man?
At the age of 13, I started writing poetry. It was just, I want to say it was an accident, but accidents are sometimes meant to happen. Ever since that accident happened, I've just been writing. And it was just life events that actually took place within my personal life and other people's personal life.
Okay.
And I was actually able to articulate those emotions and those feelings and those raw happenings in two words and just started from there. And I've actually been writing ever since. And I've never put the pen down. Started performing at the age of 23.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's impressive, man. Just a raw talent, man, to really just put it out on paper like that, man, and still continue to develop it. So
every day you still learn something new, and then you figure that you can actually go a different direction every day. So I look at my older poetry, and I look at the poetry that I write now, and it's like, wow, I really wrote that back then. And then compared to what I write now, it's like a difference in growing, but the same message and the emotion behind it is still there.
Okay, all right, that's what's up, man. You can't go, since, man, all that emotion, all that craft, man, go on and give us our first one, man.
First one I'm gonna do is Bitter.
Let me get a couple. Okay, you got it.
I just want to punch you in the back of your fucking throat. And if your mother jump in, it is gonna be murder, she wrote, because I don't like the bitch anyway. And it's a pity. You're 33 fucking years old and you're still sucking on a titty. Nigga, let that shit go. I ain't bitter. I'm just mad as hell because I gave you me on purpose. Without fail and no questions asked, I was by your side. When shit went down, I was your ride or die. Always ready to cut a motherfucker who fucked with you. And my loyalty for what? Only to be thrown back in my face because you got excited over a new swing and a new piece of ass. Oh. See, I'm a firm believer in the 80-20 rule, so you go ahead and be with your 5%. I'm not going to slash your tires, and I'm not going to put sugar in your tank. I'm too creative for that. Please remember the super glue story. I ain't bitter. I'm just mad as hell because you couldn't be up front with me. Times I lied to protect your closeted ass because you wanted to front for your boys and didn't want them to know that the only piece of ass that you was getting was really mangina. And sometimes your fucking legs went higher than mine. I ain't bitter. I'm just mad as hell because you betrayed me. From the numbers found in your phone to the condom wrappers found in your car, I should have left your ass then, but I gave you the benefit of the doubt. Then being confronted by Twan and he wanted to put his hands on me? See, my mother always told me never to hit a woman, but she always taught me to beat the bricks off a bitch. But now you're gone, no longer in my life. What a burden lifted off of me. But I ain't bitter. I'm just mad as hell. Mad as hell because I allowed you to make me bitter.
Wow. Man, wow, dude. Thank That's what's up. You know, I already heard it, man, but it's like fresh every time that I hear it, man. So, wow, man. That's
shout out to Mangina and Vaginas.
Man, that's what's up, man. I enjoy it, man. You know, just you doing your thing, man. You know what I'm saying? That's really what's up, man. So, yeah, I'm fix that in a minute. All right. But anyway, but hey, man, just appreciate it, man. That's what's up, man. So, like, what do you have coming up next, man? Just like that people can come to, attend to, just, you know what I'm saying, be looking for you.
This Sunday I have Indulge. I'm actually hosting Eclectic Sundays.
Okay, okay.
It's my first hosting gig ever.
That's what's up.
Actually came upon that by a friend of mine. She loved what I do on stage, loved what I say. She loved my personality, so she asked me to host her event, so I said, why not?
Okay.
So I'm hosting that. On the 28th of this month also, I'm being spotlighted at the Bus Boys and Poets in Hinesville on eBay night.
Okay, okay. That's what's up, man.
And then on the 31st, I actually have my own show in Mount Rainier at Arts is Everything.
Yeah.
And it's called So Be It Sunday. We're showcasing poets and comedians at the same time.
That's what's up. That's what's up, man. Oh, you busy this month.
I am a busy man. Very busy man.
That's what's up. Y'all don't, man, follow this brother, man. If you missed any part of it, follow him, man. And just and show up, man. Come out and support, man, these artists, man. They work hard for what they do. They craft. They get their craft down. They give an excellent. You know what I'm saying? So I'm out to get to give you an excellent performance, man. So, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, do what it do, man. That's what's up, man. Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
Sure, go ahead.
Okay, so with artistry and with the way that poetry and independent artists are viewed upon anyways, are actually mainstream artists, they usually wait, or artists usually wait until they're mainstream to come busting out the closet, you know, waving the rainbow flag. So with you being an open homosexual man, how has that impacted how you operate, or how the response that you get as a poet?
Honestly, when I first started performing poetry and not even thinking about me being an openly gay man, the response that I've actually gotten has actually been shockingly very well accepted.
Okay.
People just take it as for face value, because after all, it's poetry, it's art, it's just my self-expression, mm-hmm. and it's a self-expression of what's actually going on. I've actually had people come to me and actually say thank you, because there are people who won't even open their mouth and say or go to the places that I do.
Wow.
So I even had women actually come to me and say thank you, because you opened my eyes to a whole new world, and their husbands, their boyfriends, or whoever feel the same way.
Wow. Now, I've seen you perform before, and I've seen you do your thing. So you've been, you actually used to go by a different stage name, Moods.
Yes.
Then you evolved into Poetry's Child, and at some point you were just using your regular name. So with the evolution of these names, is there a purpose behind that?
There is. Moods, when I first coined the name Moods, that came from a very hurt, negative, violent place.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And as I started to evolve with my poetry, I wanted to get rid of that negative, violent place, because I was no longer venturing that avenue.
Okay.
So I wanted to get rid of that. So I dropped Moods and just went by Christopher.
Okay.
So as I went by Christopher, I still wanted to pay homage to, I still felt as though I had a stage presence and a stage name to actually to give honor to, but I didn't want to use Moods any longer. So I thought about what poetry's actually have done for me from a child up until my adulthood now. Mm-hmm. It actually gave birth to a different person, a different style of writing, a different form of writing. So Poetry's Child came about.
Shout out to Moods and Christopher that apparently got together, had some mangina, and gave birth to Poetry's Child.
Hey, that's what's up, man. We appreciate you, man. No doubt on that one, man. Definitely appreciate you. Hey, what's another one you got for us? When you come here, man, ask MJG, I'll put you to work, man.
I believe you. This one is actually called And There's Me. The story behind And There's Me is about a gay male prostitute who is speaking to the wife and the mistress about a man that they all have in common. And this is one of the poems that actually women and men honestly say, you know, you doing that is just like the best thing, because people want to ignore things like that.
Right.
They know it exists, but they don't want to talk about it.
Okay.
So I talked about it.
There you go.
At the age of 15, I talked about it.
Okay. Wow. Wow.
You bitches funny. One loves them, the other one wants them. I just fuck him for the money. Never will I get attached. He's your mistake. Late nights with streetlights is how we communicate. You didn't know I exist? Well, then maybe it's for the best. But how do you ignore the marks on his back, his legs, his neck, and his chest? See, he can keep you as the primary bitch and keep repeating that secondary bitch, but I'm that bitch. That bitch that got him eating out the palm of my hand and at command have his tongue licking the hole of my ass. And remember your first anniversary dinner when we were late? We were busy breaking into back seats of your new car. As long as his wallet opens, mm-hmm. I'm there to please. Kissing me from my ankle down to my inner thigh, sucking on my nuts with my dick laying on his left eye. And it's crazy sexy cool, because I'm a creep. He tired of the nagging, and he tolerates the bragging. But when I'm with him, I'm quiet as kept, because on his dick I'm gagging. Let this be your lesson learned, is all I'll say. Now I wish you both the best, and I hope what you have will last. But remember this, when you're sucking his dick, you're kissing my ass.
What?
That's and there's me.
Wow, dude.
I am a take it there poet.
Yeah. Hey, take it there, man. Don't be shocked by my amazement.
I'm speechless.
That's what's up, man. Poetry Childs, man. Chris Poetry Childs Thomas, man. You keep it real, dude. You keep it real, man. And you know what? Ain't it can't be mad at you for it, man. I'd rather hear the truth, man. Hear your real thoughts and don't shun around.
Can I switch seats? Because he talking about chest and scratching and nails. What's going on?
You safe.
Yeah, man. So that's what's up, man. Really appreciate what you do, how you put it together, man. And just it's awesome, man.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? The real truth, man. And just in a poetic form. That's all, man.
That's all it is.
Yeah, can't take it as you're angry or nothing like that. It's just real talk. You know what I'm saying? So I've been saying that all day, Marks.
Real talk?
Yeah, real talk all day. That's real talk, man. So, man, like, give me your information one more time, man. Just one more time.
All right, you can follow me on Twitter at mm-hmm. Poetry's Child, mm-hmm. PoetrysChild. Instagram, same name, same spelling. Facebook, Christopher Thomas, in parentheses, Poetry's Child.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you here right here live, man. This is the Cool Out Mix. If you just tuning in, man. Poetry Childs is right here blessing the mic, man, doing what he do best, man. Marcus Smoot right here, WRTR, man. And I appreciate y'all coming, man. Y'all, you know what I'm saying?
Again,
we just hold
for having us.
This is the spotlight, man. This is how we, you know what I'm saying, the whole hour is y'all's, man. So, hey, that's what's up, man. Hey, before I forget, I put out some tickets.
Uh-oh.
On Facebook, right? Before I forget.
Is this the Poetry Childs show?
Yeah. I'm saying. It is, man, but still. He might be involved. Hey, look. Two tickets to see Mike Brooks, right, at the Crystal Lounge. It's like March 17th, I believe. It's like, I got them. If you check my Facebook at Avon Cons, you'll see it. The tickets are all there. And you can call in to 202-498-2689. Give me your best three poetic lines or lyrics. And those tickets are yours. And forget the two-drink minimum. You ain't got to worry about the two-drink minimum. You can just walk in, and if you decide to drink or not, they're yours. So your best three lines, 202-498-2689. I'll take that. And the tickets are yours, two free tickets. You know what I'm saying? So that's what we do, man. And it's back to you, Chris. It's the Poetry Child show right now.
Right. Let's see what else I got.
Herpes. Oh, my bad. Oh. You can't say things
the
like that.
The devil is a liar.
Things like that around me. No, I'm kidding. Go ahead.
Oh, man.
Okay, this next poem is called Band-Aids.
Herpes, see?
It's actually a poem about child molestation, and
this young lady
in the poem is actually using sex as a form of masking her hurt and her pain, trying to gain love through it that way. And I actually had a dream about it. That's how the poem came about. You keep wearing pussy on your sleeves and allowing niggas to thieve because you equate straight fucking with true loving. 7 buns in the oven, but you don't have none of them because abortion told them you're no longer wanted, so now you have to die. You lay in your bed hurting, crying yourself to sleep because of the emotional scars you have cutting you deep. Molested at 5 and sucking dick at 6. By the age of 13, the motherfucker who caused it has you doing tricks and then saying, you know what, we have a special, and you know daddy loves you. Yeah, your mother knew, but she stayed black and blue, thinking she was protecting you while watching daddy fuck you. You go to school and you're hurt and you're ridiculed and you're teased, so you spread your legs like a rash and you allow the Boys and Girls Club to smash like ease because being fucked is the only form of love you ever knew. Lowered eyes to the ground because of the sound of your soul screaming is intense, telling yourself you have no one to talk to because this is some heavy shit. So to your knees you drop to suck the next nigga's dick and he says, I love you, baby girl. And you smile and you drop your panties and you gain another thief. But this time it's different. A trip to the doctor said that you got that three-letter thief, and you reply with tears. You ask yourself, what did I do to become this cum rag for cum stains, this substitute for love, so you choose to hate yourself because you feel that emotion is best. 3 hours later, you're found in an alley, put to rest. The band-aids you used to cover these gaping wounds could no longer nurse the infection causing you to go numb. Infection not caught in time, so death she becomes. That's band-aids.
Wow,
dude. Wow. You know, that's deep, man.
Yeah, you know, the thing that I like about that poem in particular, and shout out to Honey Bee that actually said this, that poem is one of those that delves into the Poetry's Child genre of your life right now. So that's a good thing. I mean, I like how, you know, don't get me wrong, I do like the racy other stuff and, you know, the aggressive, but I do like how that poem kind of opens up and shows the soulful side of Poetry's Child.
I call it subtle realness.
There you go.
It's not as rough as the others, but that one came to me in a dream.
In a dream?
I dreamt about it.
What?
And I had to write it. I woke up at 6 o'clock one Saturday morning and had to write the poem.
Wow.
When I wake up at 6 o'clock, I crave bacon.
right. Bacon and coffee. Yeah.
Just the coffee. The bacon.
That's your choice. Man, wow, dude. Man, you really... So, like, how much written down do you have?
Collectively, I actually, believe it or not, I counted them all yesterday. I have 475 poems.
Wow.
What?
475, and I have 5 that are unfinished and 3 that I'm actually formulating right now in my head.
Wow. So every day you focus on this?
It's not that I focus on it. I try to actually... It's not that I focus on it. It just happens. Mm-hmm. I don't... It's not something I actually ask for. It just happens.
Right. Wow.
So, and it's been this way since I actually started writing.
Mm-hmm.
And I have never, ever, never stopped.
What? Man, I don't even know how much stuff I got written down. I need to do better.
Grocery list written down.
I don't even write my grocery list down. It's all in my head. Wow, that's what's up, Chris, man. So, I'm appalled, man. Just like I'm amazed, like how well, like everything you write, you write your work, how you write it down. You got how you write it down, man, and flow with it. Like you're already thinking about your next one.
It's just not just do every day.
Wow.
And they will be started tonight.
What? Do you work?
I do.
you work?
I work. And I just keep a post-it and a pen by me all the time so I can write my thoughts down.
He's that stripper at stadium with the notepad.
No, okay. Tell me your story.
I'll write you a fantasy down like you want it. Now.
I'll put you in the poem. I got you.
I got you. Butter. That's what's up, man. And hey, we're going to go to a quick commercial real quick, man. Come back, man. Chris going to spit some more for you. Bless the mic. And, man, just hold tight, man. Hey, once again, the number is 202-498-2689. 2 tickets to Crystal Lounge to see Mike Brooks. It's the Drink and Laugh.
It's funny how money changes situations. Miscommunication leads to complications. My emancipation don't fit your equation. I was on the humble, you on every station. Someone play young Lauren like she done. Remember not to game the one of the sun. Everything you did has already been done. I know all the tricks from Prince to Kingston. My team done, major kingdom, one run. Now understand El Boogie, not violent. But if a thing tests me, run to me gun. Y'all take a threat to me. This way since creation, a groupie call you far from temptation. Now you want ball over separation, tarnish my image in the conversation. Who you gonna scrimmage like you the champion? You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you just lost one. You might win some, but you won over one. You might win some, but you just lost one. Now, how come your talk turned cold? Gain the whole world for the price of your soul. Grab hold of what you can't control. Now you all lost with a sight to behold. is no coincidence. Hypocrites always want to play innocent, always want to take it to the full out extent, always want to make it seem like good intent, never want to face it when it's time for punishment. I know you don't want to hear my opinion, then how many paths and you must choose one, and if you don't change then the rain soon comes. See, you might win some but you just lost one, you might win some but you just lost one, you might win some.
Hype now, cause y'all here. Cause y'all here, man.
Took me out my spot. Took me out of my quiet zone mode. Me bringing it. Nah, it's good.
Change it up a little bit. Yeah. Oh, darling, I see you go through your changes.
Darling, open your eyes and let me show you the light.
All right, once again, man, this is the Cool Out Mix, man, with your boy DJ Clapper. Special guest, Poetry Childs, is in the building. He dropped through the studio to bless the mic, man. I got my man Marcus Smoothie here, WRTR, is in the building, man.
That's what's up.
Hey, so we back to Chris, man. He's just killing it, man. Keeping it real with all of us, man. So hope you enjoy everything. If you don't, that's on you. Still, those tickets are available, man. I'm telling you, nobody call, then guess what? I'm going. And I'm getting two drinks. I'm gonna work that one out.
If so, y'all don't go, I'm gonna go, and I'm gonna give him three of my favorite lyrics. It's gonna be something like "Mangina, licking butts, and whatever you say."
Take three of Chris's and cross reference. Hey, that's what's up, man. So, all right, man, y'all call whatever. Marcus is claiming them. You know what I'm saying? He going. All right, so we back to you, Chris, man. So we appreciate you being here, man. Blessing the mic, man. We are really enjoying it, and we having a good time in the studio, man. So that's what's up, man. So hey, it's back to you, brother.
All right, this is a new piece, never heard ever, and I was going to debut it actually from my spotlight, but I'm gonna do one on here. It's called "How Dare You." It's actually looking to a personal side of my life. You used to have a hold on me. Living with you made me scared to breathe the very air surrounding me. I never knew when I was going to have a new cut, bruise, or scrape because you felt it was necessary to teach me another lesson. You were my constant reminder of why I wanted death to befriend me and show me that side of eternity and forget everything about me that made me human. I never imagined a hate so strong could crawl from the pit of my soul aiming towards you, but internalized for years in the heart of an innocent child screaming silently because I was too scared to tell. How dare you make me feel like that? Every inch of my existence would boil at the thought of my fault.
It's all right. You got it.
Every inch of my existence would boil at the thought of me coming home after school knowing I had to face you and your husband's anarchy. The stained laugh of a broken child's smile plagued me. Wearing loose clothes to shield the pain placed upon me by your fist of fury. Days I missed from school because the blood would not stop pouring. Stop crying like a bitch and take it like a man was always your closest statement. Closed my eyes and wished I could die in my sleep. The rising hate of an innocent child. How dare you make me feel like that? Oh my God, how I wish February 2nd, 1992 never came to exist. That night the main woman in my life was taken from me and I felt my reality torn away. Every time I was beat down like a nigga in the streets, I hated her for leaving me to suffer in a world I did not want or make. Lord, Father, God, forgive me for I'm about to sin again. I pray you end my life and reunite me and mama again. This body is hurt and this mind is crying and my soul no longer speaks to me. This was the prayer of a 12-year-old boy, but it was never answered, and the muffled cries heard invited more cuts, bruises, and scrapes. Because it was said, crying is for the weak. How dare you make me feel like that? For so long, I roamed this earth with pieces to a puzzle scrambled by the way you chose to love me and prepare me for life. That innocent child within, I can still hear a cry from time to time. I can still recall the taste of your fist against my mouth. I used to stand as a broken bruise, but now I'm a bruise, but not broken, with the emotions I'm still having to mend. For my own sake, I forgave you a long time ago, but I'll never forget. How dare you make me feel like that?
Wow,
dude.
That was deep.
Yeah, that was deep, man. Yeah,
it was kind of hard getting through that.
Wow. That's all right, man. Appreciate it, man. You know what I'm saying? You like, your gift is touching other people, man. Like you said, what you said earlier, your gift touching other people, man. I might have touched somebody, man. They may reach out to Chris, man. So if you felt that, man, you share that, man, reach out to him, man. And his brother tell you how to just express your feelings, man. You know what I'm saying? So that's what's up. Poetry style, man.
Yeah, poems come from a dark place. Gay people are usually a little bit more upbeat. What's the problem? You're the opposite.
No,
you beat me. Are you serious? My.
I'm the flip side of that reality.
Apparently. Gay people are like, yay, hey, butt sex, you're all, oh, yeah. Life, you know. Oh, okay.
Oh, man. Hey, man. It's all right, man. You got light and dark, dude. It's all right.
That's how I feel.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. So, hey, man, appreciate it, man. So, when is all this going to get on the CD, man?
You know, I'm actually trying to get that in the making right now as we speak.
Okay.
I actually have a few pieces that I actually want on CD. There are pieces that I've actually are brand new. Uh-huh. And the piece of that I really have not shared. I'm actually trying to rewrite and reorganize the stanzas. So
yeah, because you know I asked you that before. You know I asked you that before, man. We need to like put it in rotation. I can tell you, man. I can mix some R&B in your poetry in this mug right here.
Oh,
man,
I believe you.
Yeah, wine, everything, sangria, whatever you drink, man. People gonna kick back.
Work for me.
Hey, there you go. There you go. Hey, man, if you just tuned in, man, Chris Poetry Charles Thomas is right here in the studio, WLVS, man. He's kicking it with us, man. Marcus Smooth is kicking it with us, man, from WRTR. And it's all Chris, man. So, you know what I'm saying? You got another one for us, Chris?
What I actually have is a haiku. I have three haikus I'm going to read.
Okay.
For everyone who does not know what a haiku is, it's a three-line. There you go. Poem, mm-hmm. Japanese poem, mm-hmm. 575, five syllables, seven syllables, five syllables, 17 syllables altogether.
Mm-hmm.
First one I had, I actually did for Black History Month because my nephew pissed me off because sometimes he's my nephew. That's all I'll say it that way.
Right.
And this came about from him.
Mm-hmm.
Negativity plagues our community. Ancestors ashamed.
Good one, good one.
Negativity.
I hope you caught that one.
Nice.
Negativity.
Mm-hmm.
This one,
mm-hmm.
Angel I am not, so far from being perfect, a work in progress.
What's that one come from?
That one's actually about me.
Is that why you call yourself the fallen angel on Twitter?
I am a fallen angel because I'm not perfect.
Explain that.
Fallen angel meaning I'm a good person, but I'm nowhere near to being perfect, so I don't want to be put on that pedestal. I still want people to remember that I'm not perfect. I'm not this idol that they actually claim for me to be. I still have my own baggage. I still have my own issues mm-hmm. that I'm actually working on. So I'm an angel who's trying to actually get his full set of wings, so hence fallen angel.
Okay.
Okay. All right. All right, I can understand that. Then we all fallen angels, huh?
That's how
it
be. Okay.
Or most of them.
Y'all, I'm perfect.
I'm perfect. I ain't perfect, man. I ain't about to say all that. Hey, man, so hey, that's what's up, man. Wow. You got another one for us, man? Because I'm sitting here and enjoy it, man. So I hope everybody else is, man.
Thank you.
And you know what I'm saying? We're going to do this.
This one is actually dedicated to someone who think they know it all. I'm not going to say their name, but they know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
People who think they know it all make my ass itch.
Mm.
Just shut the fuck up.
Oh.
That's my last haiku.
Wow. 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 So, can you show us how to write, man?
I can show you how to write.
Okay. Marcus, you ain't on
hey,
that?
Hey, do your thing. I'm ready to learn.
All right, what you want to learn how to write?
How to get it on paper, man. Sounds like somebody out there, even myself, how do we get it like I try it and I just throw it. I just throw it. It's better in my head than it is on paper.
That has a smartphone or smart device, tablet, whatever it may be, whatever you think, I always tell people this, mm-hmm. whatever you think, your mm-hmm. thought is not a wasted thought. It's a thought for a reason. Write it down.
Okay.
And then you can build upon that thought
mm-hmm.
and just keep building upon it. By the time you know, you actually have a poem or a story or a chapter to a novel or mm-hmm. a short story or an essay, no matter what it is. Just keep building on that thought. For example, you can walk out here and say, oh, I see DC police out here arresting somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Thought. But then you just go ahead and you just continue to build upon that thought
mm-hmm.
and just go from there.
Shout out to the crackhead outside getting arrested.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's how it primarily begins.
Story at 8. Poem at 8. That's what's up, man. Because, all right, I don't know about anybody else, man, but you're right. Like they said, all right, should a person start small or start big or, you know, a little bit longer than a haiku?
It actually depends on the haiku or the actual piece. It actually depends on what avenue you want to take it. If you just want to get something quick and out there.
Mm-hmm.
Haiku. It depends, but not everyone can write a haiku.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to do a poem, same thing. Just building upon that thought is just actually contorting the words to fit that mode that mm-hmm. you're actually in at that present time.
Do you got to rhyme?
You don't have to rhyme.
Cause, I mean, like I heard people say, oh, you know, they may make a little, their statement is like a rhyme. They say, oh, I could be a poet. But that's somebody's thinking that that's poetry, but it's not.
As I've learned since I've been writing poetry, I was one of those people who thought that every mm-hmm. other word or every other line had to rhyme, mm-hmm. but that's not the case.
Mm-hmm.
As long as you actually, again, have that thought and you're building upon that thought and you actually have that story going
mm-hmm.
and you're actually holding and you're pulling that person in with that story,
okay,
it's a poem. Because you're actually saying how you feel, the metaphors, the similes, everything that you have thrown in there is mm-hmm. actually working for you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Roses are red.
Yeah.
Violets are blue.
Yeah.
Bacon is brown.
And your cholesterol is through.
There you go.
Right off the top. He finished it for you. Smoke got a poem. Hey, you got another one for us,
and
man?
I actually have, before well, I read another one, I have mm-hmm. two books. One of which I'm actually trying to get out of archive right now.
Okay.
Titled Moods Reign.
Uh-huh.
And the other one is titled Voices Carry. I meant to bring them both in, but I forgot.
Okay. But
Voices Carry, that will be for sale again in June. I'm taking okay. that back off the shelves, actually put back in distribution, so that'll be for sale. And I'm still working on
Voices. All right, in June, come back, man, so we can promote that for you.
No problem. I'm also working on my third and fourth book of poetry.
Uh-huh.
And they're also in the works titled Emotions of an Echo and Diamond Dragonfly.
So you identify yourself as far as poetry, as far as like emotions. So you don't speak about anything else, but they're more geared on.
Actually, I don't even consider myself a poet, believe it or not. I actually consider myself to be a voice.
Okay.
Because of the graphic content that I have that people don't want to take it there with, and mm-hmm. then the actual emotion, like dealing with child abuse or sexual abuse, any mm-hmm. type of thing of that nature.
Mm-hmm.
That's just giving myself a voice for people who don't have the strength to speak up or know how to actually to articulate that feeling or that emotion.
But isn't poetry about expressions anyway?
It is.
Okay.
Let me ask you this. You know, you're all about evolution. You're mm-hmm. from Fallen Angel to Moods to Poetry's Child. Like, your stories and your poetry reflects that of someone who is constantly evolving. Do you have any poetry that represents you that when you were in a solitary kind of a mood or a solitary point in your life?
I do, but I don't have any with me.
Okay.
And I don't have any of them memorized, unfortunately. Okay. I will mm-hmm. share this. My very first poem I ever written in my life,
mm-hmm.
since I'm being candid here, it was actually a suicide letter.
Oh.
I was going mm-hmm. to commit suicide at one point in my life. And mm-hmm. at the age of 13, that's when I first started writing poetry. And it was, I started out the letter, To Whom It May Concern.
Mm-hmm.
And then by the time I finished, it wasn't a letter. It was something else.
Okay.
And so then I read it, and then I rewrote it, and then I read it again, and then I rewrote it, read it and rewrote it. And by mm-hmm. then, that's when my first poem was born, and I simply titled it To Whom It May Concern.
Okay.
So every time I had one of those feelings where I wanted to, again, coming from that violent place, cause harm to mm-hmm. heal someone else, I would write it down in the poem, and I would actually kill myself mm-hmm. or kill that person in that poem.
Wow.
To actually get rid of that emotion at that present time.
Okay.
Excellent.
Wow. Wow, that's excellent, man.
So that's how that happened.
Okay, I'm learning, man.
Do you think?
I'm going to have one soon.
Oh.
Hey, what else?
What's it going to be about, Clapper?
Huh?
What's it going to be about?
I touched you.
Oh.
I already got the title.
Oh.
it's all, I already got the title, man. So I just put it together.
I mean, and one thing I do want to do is,
yeah.
if I can, I want to give a shout out to somebody.
Go ahead.
Actually, first of all, WRTR Radio.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
They are part of the reason why I actually got back into doing poetry. And Honeybee was one of the ones who actually
shout out to Honeybee.
Yeah. Shout out to Honeybee.
Mm-hmm.
Who was available for birthday parties and private events.
She does role playing too. I heard she likes to play pinata.
Yes.
What?
No.
Okay.
I touched you.
Shout out to Twist, Poetically J Star, mm-hmm. J October, mm-hmm. K Rob, MJG, mm-hmm. DC Poet, Victorious Robinson, mm-hmm. and all the other poets that I've actually come encountered with. They have been very, very phenomenal, and I've actually have grown, have been inspired by every single one of them. So mm-hmm. shout out to all those great poets there.
Yeah, shout out to them, man. I didn't think I'd be DJing at poetry events ever. And I ended up with, I was ready to be in clubs. I used to DJ like motorcycle. I used to be in motorcycle clubs and DJ there, but I never thought I'd do poetry. Like, be at a poetry event.
Happen.
Yeah. So now, and I've been there, I'm like, I don't even want to go in the club now.
It's a different type of a feeling.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
What kind of songs do they look for in like poetry kind of venues?
they typically go for neo soul to strictly soul music or jazz, depending again on the vibe that you're trying or the atmosphere you're trying to create. Mm-hmm. Like I've been to some that actually just use straight hip hop, and actually some of it worked, and surprisingly it worked and it shocked me. Right. But typically it's strictly jazz, R&B, neo soul, or just strictly soul music that's actually used to create that atmosphere, like the Love Jones era.
Gotcha.
Type of poetry.
Gotcha. I was thinking, you know, you go into, you know, thinking it's certain a certain kind of mood, and then all of a sudden you hear,
bust that pussy open, then I tell her, bring it.
And then people be like, oh, you know, like.
Yeah, because yeah, you know. they told me, say, hey, clap, you got to get set the mood. And I'm like, huh? You know. So, but I learned real fast.
But yeah,
so.
It's all about what the mm-hmm. host mm-hmm. is trying, or the actual promoter. It's all about the atmosphere that they want to create and the crowd they want to draw in.
Right. Wow.
Right.
Awesome.
All right, that's what's
so
up,
the
man.
The music you put out is going to be the people who you mm-hmm. draw in.
Okay. Okay.
Cool.
That's what's up, man. Hey, do your thing, man. I know you got one more for us.
All right. This one is called Director's Cut. Is this orchestra of smiles worth my while, or is this my cue to exit the stage before I'm casted in your lead of heartbreaking masterpiece? Your scripted scent laced with the heaven-sent kiss of laughter allures me, but I'm too afraid to read the next act. You tone my mind, and you manage to find memories frozen and suspended still with no means of escape. I rehearsed this scene before, and never once was I nominated for an award, but I always played the best part. So before the curtains rise and I share that glimmer in my eye to embrace this soul connection, I sigh with uncertainty. Do I accept this role of red carpet love, or am I just another director's cut?
Wow.
Wow, dude. Okay. Definitely put that one on CD, man.
I was thinking about this one, yeah. But I want to expand more on it.
Okay. All right. We're going to put some music behind it. I don't know. Marcus, you got, I don't know.
Hey, yeah. Bust that pussy open. Tell him, bring it. But no.
Director's cut.
No, but shout out to you, Clapper, because you are in the community. You everywhere like Visa do. You are supporting. You're supporting the artists. You're supporting the poets. And,
appreciate it.
You know, you support us. Yeah. You support other jocks. It's awesome. You are like a true hero in the radio world.
Hey, so. Appreciate it, man. I enjoy. I just enjoy. Appreciate it, man. Cause I just enjoy. People being able to express themselves, man. However, man, like say there was an intern here, he needed the band that I had here. I actually had a band in here, right here.
Wow.
And first one to do it, you can check out the YouTube videos, New Retro, and he liked them. He's an intern at the Art Institute.
Right.
He said, "Clap, man, I really like your show. I like what you do. Can I get that band? Can you help me out? I need to get it for a grade, live recording." Hey, made that happen. And this dude, I know he got a good grade. Audio visual got involved, man. It's a good turnout. So I just enjoy positive things coming out of the whole deal, man. So and that's what I do, man. Shout out to y'all, man. I even pick up more, man. You don't know how I listen. I got my Bluetooth. I'm listening to WRTR, man. Oh. And then last night, I was, when I seen your post, man, I was like, I mean, hold on, let me hit it. Okay, phone. All right, here you go. So I was doing all this
we
to try to make it happen,
we
man.
Appreciate it. We
so the smoothness, man. And so like I'm constantly learning. You know what I'm saying? This is. How to put the show together, how to do a show, man, how to support. Because it was, you know, just me by myself. You know what I'm saying? So, and it's still kind of by myself, man. I DJ on my show, host my show, and all stuff. But hey, if anybody else want to come, that's cool. As long as you had the right attitude. Yep. You know what I'm saying?
That's all that matters.
Yeah. Poetry Child, I want to ask you one last question.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you see yourself in the next 5 years as far as your career and as far as your spoken word artistry?
Mm-hmm.
In the next 5 years, I actually do see myself having my own venue, possibly my own club, doing nothing, catering to nothing but poetry.
Wow.
And to the arts, because that's where my heart is. It's the actual arts of everything, whether you paint, you tap, whatever. Just
right.
That's where I see myself. Just supporting those who are actually in the art and actually creating an avenue for those who don't know how to get their foot into the door.
Shout because out to Chris's Poetry and Nails coming up in 2015, 2016, 2017. Yeah. Poetry, chicken and nails.
And nails and pedicure. Get your feet done and listen to poetry. Hey, man, I really enjoyed y'all being here, man. I guess they know that's my time. I don't see Eric's signal, man, but this is close to my time. So, Okay, now I see it. So this is closing my time. I really appreciate it, man. Please follow this brother, man. Go ahead. You got time to get your information out there. How people can get a hold of Poetry Child.
Again, my Twitter is at Poetry Child, PoetryZchild. Instagram is the same name. Facebook, Christopher Thomas, in parentheses, is Poetry Child.
And then you got my man Marcus Smooth. How you get a hold of Marcus, man?
Oh, you get a hold of me with some firm hands. And no, I'm kidding.
And some bacon.
Yeah, if you got bacon, you can lure me into any trap. But no, my Twitter is at Marcus Smoot, at Honeybee1980, are my co-host, and at Radio Roachbug. You can also follow us at WRTR Radio and catch us every Saturday right here on Listen Vision at 11 a.m.
Hey, that's what's up, man. And you can catch me here every Thursday from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. It's the Cool Out Mix, man. Every third Thursday is support the hip hop indie artists. But any other time after that is neo soul and poetry. Just still continue supporting the poetry movement, man. The neo soul artists, send your submissions to djclapper1@gmail.com. djclapper1@gmail.com. And also, March 30th is my event, man. It's Poetry R&B. Got a live band. And it's at the Andes Art Gallery in Temple Hills. And we're doing it big right there, man. So hit me at Yvonne Collins on Twitter. Hit me at Yvonne Collins on Facebook. And email me, and we're going to put all that together, man, and you're more than welcome to come. That's my time, each and every Thursday, WLVS Radio.